Vive le français! Bonjour chers amis! So today we are together here to read the label of the wine, pour lire l'étiquette. So let's read this one. So on this side you can see the name, so that's the name of the wine, okay? La Rose de Cruau. Then you can see the place where it comes from, where it's produced. So this one is Saint-Julien. Saint-Julien is in fact a village, a city. And all around the village, the herds, that's all around the village. And Saint-Julien is quite famous. It's a place that's quite famous for the wine. And then there's the age. So here is 2001. So 2001 is already old wine. Okay. Let's look at another one. We have here Mouton Cadet. So we have Mouton Cadet, that's the name of the wine. Then you have here the year, 2002. Then you arrive Bordeaux, Bordeaux. So what can you say about this? You can say that, of course, the Bordeaux is much bigger than Saint-Julien. Bordeaux is... Saint-Julien is one small city. And I think, in fact, Saint-Julien is inside Bordeaux. Saint-Julien is inside... Wait, Saint-Julien is inside Bordeaux. But Saint-Julien is a small village and all the land around the village. And Bordeaux is a very big space. So when you have a very big space like this, you can see maybe the wine is not as good. It's the same as the chocolate. If you buy the chocolate from the supermarket, they will take the chocolate from everywhere and mix it together. So the taste is not going to be very specific. But if you take the chocolate from one specific area, then the taste will be like, wow, incredible, because it's the chocolate from one specific area. So it's better when you have a very, very narrow area where they produce the wine. So that's what you can say about this Saint-Julien. On the other side, you will see something where they say mis en bouteille à la propriété. I'm not sure if you can read it. Mis en bouteille à la propriété means the wine is bottled up inside the property. So this is always good when it's bottled up inside the property, because it means it's a producer, and that's what we can see here. Récoltant, it means on the label here we can see récoltant means producer. It's not négociant. Okay, so this one is négociant. Okay. What else can we see? We can see the degree of alcohol. So the degree of alcohol, so this is 12.5 here, 12.5, and this one is 13% degree of alcohol. Degree of alcohol never varies a lot. It can vary between different type of wine, like we have here the rosé. Normally rosé is lighter, you see, this one is 12%, but normally the rosé is lighter wine, so it's not so strong. Normally the rosé, 12%, normally rosé can be more like 11%. So what else can we see in here? We say appellation Bordeaux contrôlée. Appellation Bordeaux contrôlée, which means it comes from Bordeaux and it has the appellation of Bordeaux. So it means it is being produced in Bordeaux and it means it respects the criteria of the AOC. So they put the right type of grape inside and the right dosage and they respect a little bit the things. Here, it's what it is, is they say appellation Saint-Julien contrôlée. So it's the appellation is not from the wall of Bordeaux. The appellation is from this small village, from Saint-Julien, which means the wine is very, very specific. You know, if the wine is produced from a place that's not famous, they will just simply say Bordeaux, because nobody knows. But Saint-Julien is a specific place, and people know the wine from Saint-Julien is very different, because you have a microclimate, a microclimat, micro weather. It's maybe a small place, the wine there are very old, the weather there is very good, there's not too much wind, there's enough sun, so the wine is going to be very special. So that's how it is. Here there is something more that they put behind. So they put the different cépages. Can you read in black? So Cabernet Sauvignon, Merlot, Cabernet Franc, Petit Verdot, Malbec. Can you see? Cabernet Sauvignon, Merlot, Petit Malbec. Okay. And so this does, and there's something else they say, vendange manuel. Vendange manuel. It means they will pick up the grape by hand. They will pick up the grape by hand. So what does it mean, vendange manuel? Quite often it means the grape will be better quality, because when they can check by hand, the grapes that are not good, they will put them on one side. The grapes that are good, they will put them on the other side. So they can really check what's good, what's not, and the quality of the wine will be a little bit better. And they can, vendange manuel, so that's always better. Vinification en cuve bois, élevage en barrique. So this is always good. So they will put the wine inside the wooden the wooden barrel for 12 to 14 months. So after they pick up the grape, then they will put it in one place for 12 to 14 months in the wooden stuff. And before that, they will put it in a big cube, and after they will put it in a small wooden things. So that's what you can see about it. Let's check another one. Appellation Côte de Provence. Bon, this one, you see. Côte de Provence. So it's a Provence wine. And they say appellation Provence contrôlée, which means it comes from the whole of Provence. Provence is very big. This one is also interesting, I think, this one. Why? Because you can see au Médoc, and it's called Cru Bourgeois. Cru Bourgeois, it's a reward. Every year there will be the competition, and only the top wine of this area, they will be called Cru Bourgeois. So if you see Cru Bourgeois, you know it's a good wine. It's a wine that comes from au Médoc, I think it's in the Rhône. And then this wine that are Cru Bourgeois, they are the top wine of this place. You can see the year. You can see the year. Château. Château doesn't mean anything. Château means nothing. Château means castle, but it doesn't mean anything about the quality of the wine. And they say Grand Vin. Grand Vin also doesn't mean anything. It's just appellation that matters. So appellation. Appellation. Okay. People like when they see appellation Pomerol contrôlée. But I have another one here that I will check. Appellation Pomerol contrôlée. So here you can see that's also interesting because they say Pomerol. Pomerol is the name of a city. So Pomerol is a very small area. It's not like Bordeaux. It's not like Omédoc. So it means this wine is good because it's a small area. It comes from a small area. Then you have the year, 2007. Then they say mise en bouteille au château. So it means it's bottled up inside the property. So it means it must be a good wine. It's already. And then they say Grand Vin de Bordeaux. Okay. They don't say Bordeaux wine, you see. They say Vin de Pomerol, because Pomerol is a famous place in Bordeaux. And Grand Vin de Bordeaux. Merci, au revoir.